Welcome to the GLR Adobe Campus. In this video, we're going to take a look at the assignment number 3 already in the InDesign course. And in this case, we're going to make a postcard template. Let's make a template over here and give it a name already. So this is going to be my postcard template. It's always a good idea to give your name, give your document a name already in this dialog window. And we are going to work with millimeters in this case. That can be something different, of course, in the test. I'm going to stick with 150 millimeters width and 100 millimeters wide. So that's giving me a landscape orientation. I just want to have one page and I don't need any facing pages because we're going to make a front and a back end only of this postcard. I'm not going to worry about the columns as well, but of course I need to have one column by default. And of course, with one column, you don't need to bother with the column gutter as well. I do need to dial in some margins, and the margins is the area around your document. Not outside, but inside. It's a visual idea for you as a designer to know, please stay away from the sides of your documents. Very important for text, etc. So we're going to focus on 6 millimeters in this assignment, and we're going to add in the bleed over here. And bleed is, of course, very, very important. Not as important as the slug area. Slug area is even outside the bleed area where we can put in some extra information for the printer to make sure that he's going to read that after the document has been printed. But I don't need any slug area outside of the bleed area. So this is by default my beautiful new document. Let's create the document. And this is a very blank, empty canvas to work on. So we need to add some extra things, some extra elements to the document in order to create the nice template. So let's start with a nice graphic frame over here with these rectangle frame tools over here and the ones with the big cross inside. Well, those are the placeholders for you to put in your images, in this case on the background, the beautiful large documents are going to be placed there, a Photoshop document. And we need to have some extra text frames as well, front side of the postcard. So let's create by default something like this with the type tool. When you click and drag, you will get your type area. And in this case, I want to make sure that this has positioned exactly as in my sketch. So it's going to be focusing on the reference point over here on the left top corner. So this left top corner, representing this area over here, needs to have these numbers. That's going to be located on 87 millimeters on the x-axis, and on the y-axis it's going to be 57.5 millimeters. There we go. And it's going to be a width of 60 millimeters and a height of 20 millimeters. Not 600, 60 millimeters. There you go. So this is my first text area. And with an Alt and drag or Option and drag on your keyboard, you can make a copy. Only this copy needs to be a height of 10 millimeters. And the Y position is slightly different. That's going to be 82.5 millimeters. There we go. And these are the elements that you need to have on your front end of your postcard. And once again, this is going to be our template. So let's make another page over here. So let's add in another page. And of course, it's going to be the back end of your postcard. So let's create another page. And I need to have a nice rectangle over here as well, covering the back side of the postcard, including the bleed area, of course. Let's add in another text frame over here. Something like that. And I need to have the same elements over here as we've got on. We need to have a copy of that later on. And there needs to be an area for a QR code as well. So let's dial in the numbers over here to start off with. This is going to be a text frame of 40 millimeters width and 30 millimeters height. There we go. The image opacity for the background image always needs to be a 40%. So although this is a placeholder, I can tell it to have an opacity of 40%, so make it more transparent, let more light come through the image. And I need to have the QR code as well, and there's going to be an image frame over here. And that needs to have a width and a height of 20 millimeters. There we go. Exactly positioned on the margin of 6 millimeters. There we go. Now let's make the copy of this element and this element. Command C. Command Alt Shift V will position it directly in the new page. And of course, we can scale it down to 60%, but I want to have it scale downwards to the right bottom corner. There we go. And this is exactly what I want to have in my template. So I need to save this document as a template. So let's hit File and Save and choose from the document formats for our InDesign template. Make a brand new folder for it. There we go. And this is my postcard template. Save. So now when I want to start working on my template for the series of postcards that I want to make, I need to create a new document based on a template. So I'm not gonna go for new because that will give me a new document, but I want to open my recently created template. There we go. And then open as normal. It will give me an untitled document, all the elements that were created inside of the template. But now I can really start with creating my own postcard for the concert. Let's hit save. So there you go. That's how to create a template and how to make a new document based on the template.